Oh, I'm feeling very good. Yeah, this is the best feeling we've had. The relief is amazing.
The relief has been a long time coming. In 2015, Australian Hasan Askree flew to Pakistan to care for his elderly parents. 5 years later, the Sydney risk analyst was suddenly arrested.
They barged into our home and just everyone in the family was so traumatised and so confused.
His crime? Drafting a letter, one he didn't even send, calling for the resignation of the chief of Pakistan's army.
Actually, we didn't know whether he was alive or dead for months after that because we didn't know where he was. He was just kind of missing.
It's been really unbelievably hard. I feel like it's been really hard to even be happy at a happy moment, even to properly laugh, properly have fun.
After the family broke their silence on the project, the Australian government turned up the heat. And overnight, the news Hasan's family had been waiting for.
Look who is here. Say hello to...
You, babe.
Hello, babe.
Dari, dekhi.
If I had to make a wish, it would be I wish all four of them could just get on a plane and go to Sydney. For us, Sydney is heaven.
Thank God, he's looking good otherwise.
Except for the beard.
Joining us now is Hasan and his sister Zahra. Look at you two. First of all, after two long years, does this feel real?
It's surreal in many ways.
I can't believe it. I just need to touch him all the time. He's there. He's not going anywhere. He's here, finally.
Oh, Hasan, how are you feeling?
It's hard to explain, I think. I've been looking forward to this day when it'll happen. Sometimes I think maybe the feelings were so overwhelming that didn't know what to do about them. However, the foremost thing was freedom. I cherish every little bit of the freedom I get now. So even if it's moving in and out of a room, that's a freedom I didn't have.
So good to see those big, beautiful smiles. How did you get the news, Hasan, that you were going to be released?
It was stepwise. I went to the appeals court and the decision was given right in front of me. So that was the first step. Big relief. However, at that time, I don't think I smiled very much. So people were going, okay, do you know what happened? I know, yes, of course I know what happened.
Well, not so long ago, it felt like this wasn't really going anywhere. So what changed to get to this point?
I think going to the media was the best decision we made. It was long due and we had tried everything. And then the pressure which came from the Australian government, your work from the project was amazing, but the piece that Hamish did for the project was unbelievable. And it just, the project questioned the government, what are you doing about it? After that, thing started rolling. The first time that the High Commission went to see Hasan, that didn't happen for 2 years. They didn't get the authorization for that to actually go and meet him, and that started happening. And most of you, the media, I think you people rock. You change lives. Thank you for that.
Well, guys, it looks like the celebrations are well underway. What are you looking forward to now that you're out, Hasan?
I want to lift that pause button on my life. I think that's the thing. It's such a waste of life, a waste of time, that you're just day in and day out doing nothing. So things to look forward to, what has happened, I would like to think about it as something dead and buried. I move on. There's more to life than dwelling about the past.
Zahra, that grin tells me you look like a woman with a plan. What have you got in store for Hasan?
I want him to go to Australia and I can look after the parents. And he's been telling me, no, you go back to Australia. You have a family there. I look after them. So I do not want to fight in the first day. So I'm just holding.
That's postponed to later today.
Hasan and Zara, you have a lot of catching up to do. We really appreciate your time tonight and we're thrilled for you, Hasan.
Thank you for all your help.
I'm really, really thank everyone of you from the bottom of our heart. Thank you.